I assumed CNN over the course of the years got more and more dishonest with the American people and began to just lie slowly over the course of the years to the point where it is now where they just don't care. But we were so naive back in the late 80s and early 90s when CNN really took off. It was during the first Gulf War.
Thank you. Thank you. Anthony Cumia in for Infowars.com. Man, a lot has transpired since I was last on. Once again, the violence and the violent tone of the left has an effect. Has an effect. I don't understand how they get away from what they did early on in the Trump campaign and the election, saying that this right-wing alt-right movement that that was spreading such violence amongst this country, their words, oh, they're inciting people to violence. Everybody, Trump supporters and the right. Oh my goodness. If Trump doesn't win, my God, we're going to see riots in the streets from these horrible right-wing violent supporters of Donald Trump. So many magazine covers and mainstream media news coverage of them just predicting the future, that if Trump lost the election, we were going to see violence that we've never seen before. Well, when Obama was elected twice, believe me, the right, the conservatives, Republicans, whatever you want to call everybody on that side, none too happy, none too happy. And they'd like you to think it was a racial thing, but it was his policies. No one in their right mind that is pro-American, pro-American worker, was in support of President Obama. Were there riots in the streets? Was there violence? Truth of the matter is, in 8 years of a African-American president in what is supposed to be one of the most racist nations in the world, the United States of America, I know, it's hard to even fathom. No one ever took a pot shot at him. No one ever. There was a nut that ran into the White House, but I don't think his goal was to do the president any harm. Truth of the matter is, no one perpetrated any violence or even attempted violence on the first African American president of the United States. That's that violent, right wing, maniacal group of people. NRA, they have guns. Look out, it's crazy. Not one person attempted to assassinate President Obama. Now we see what happens after Donald Trump wins. Boy, we certainly did see an increase in violence, violent rhetoric, rioting, destruction of property, assaults, lawlessness, arson. This came from the tolerant, progressive left. The ones that were so worried that the right was going to lose their minds and burn the country down. The tolerant left have taken to assassinations, as we saw a couple of weeks ago in the ballpark over there in Alexandria, trying to kill as many Republican congressmen as possible. That's the tolerant left. Yet they continue. You watch that lying mainstream media. They will continue to tell you that this is Trump's fault. This is the alt-right
getting people so riled up that they feel compelled now to take up arms and commit violence. And if you do not believe that the completely left-wing mainstream media is culpable in this, you're out of your mind. This is one of the most obvious things we've seen. There have been calls to violence put out on mainstream media. This isn't hidden. This isn't some secret plan that we don't know about that has to be investigated and looked into, and the layers of the onion have to be peeled away to see what's happening. Where is this violent rhetoric coming from that is inciting people to commit violence and murder? Oh, it's the news. It's what people consider the news. This is insane to me that it's how blatantly obvious does it have to get? How right in your face does this have to get before even the most mentally incapable human beings in this country go, yeah, yes, I absolutely see that mainstream media is attempting to twist minds for their own agenda. And that does include calling for murder of people on the right. They also blatantly call for the elimination of people through slander, libel, smear campaigns. We've seen it. We've seen it. If you are a viewer or listener to InfoWars, you know that Megyn Kelly and her hack job that she did on Alex Jones was exposed by Alex. I mean, thank God Alex has been through enough to know not to trust these people. The sweet talk you get, and I've been through it over the years. I understand myself and Opie when I was with the Opie and Anthony show. We got called by Bill O'Reilly to do a piece on the American youth. We're like, all right, we could do a story on that. And we get called in. And again, we heard the same stuff Alex heard from Megan. It's not a hit piece. It's going to be great. It's going to be fun. They always say it's going to be fun. These are con artists. They have an agenda and they will always adhere to it, no matter what they tell you. Oh, it's not going to be a hit piece. It's going to be great. It's going to be so good for you. And then you get there, you sit in the seat, you're on their turf, you're on their home field, as it is. They are completely in charge of what the people finally see through editing. And they slam you. They slam you with questions that are a smear campaign. So we were able to see that, thank God. Like I said, Alex is smart enough to know to record these things as they're happening and not be made to look like a fool once they get done with their edit hack job and put it up there. But that's the media. Don't for a second believe this is news. You know what I found out very recently? I assumed CNN, over the course of the years, got more and more dishonest with the American people and began to just lie slowly over the course of the years to the point where it is now where they just don't care. But we were so naive back in the late 80s and early 90s when CNN really took off. It was during the first Gulf War. And I never knew this until very recently. That was all a sham. That was all dishonest reporting. When they had all those reporters over in Saudi Arabia, we saw them in Bahrain and Riyadh and Tel Aviv over in Israel. And I just found out recently it was a set. They were on a set looking at the sky going, oh, I think there's some Scud missiles coming in. Quick, gas. Put the gas mask on. And watching this in the early 90s was so compelling. It was addictive. Yeah, these are some of the clips. They're on a set. That's a fan blowing on that palm tree. They set up a fan to make it look like they were outside. And I was shocked at this because I didn't think this dishonesty by what we actually thought was the news was a scam. And that, look at this, a set. And that they were always dishonest and always agenda-driven. They weren't where they said they were. They weren't in danger of a Scud missile or a gas attack. We're on a set. And we bought it up. And the second the American people looked at that and trusted it as much as we trusted our nightly news with Walter Cronkite, the tech offensive. The second we believed it and the second they realized we were watching, they started just BSing us on a daily basis. And they've only stepped it up over the course of the years to the point they are at now, where it's newsertainment, it's entertainment programming based on the news. It's like a parody show that is making money hand over fist through sponsors. And as we all know, the only way to get sponsors on board is to approach them and say, look how many people watch our show. And if all the news stations are doing the same news, you have to step it up, don't you? By lying, by being blatantly dishonest, and by putting people on sets and telling the American people it's news when in fact it is 100% complete lies. Don't be fooled, people. You're not getting news there. You are not getting the news there. We'll be back in mere moments. Don't go anywhere. Anthony Cumia from Compound Media in for Infowars.com. Be back in a second or two.
In ancient times, man roamed the earth in a constant state of hunting or being hunted. Introducing Caveman, where cutting-edge science meets ancient super nutrients. Secure your bottle right now at InfoWarsStore.com.